want to see WPC Paige.
Oh, well, she might be out, sir. Anything I can help with?
No, I want to see her. You just tell her it's urgent.
Well, tell me what it's about.
I'm turning myself in. I want to confess to a murder.
One empty case in the chamber.
Well, at least we know it's been fired.
What do you want me to do with this?
Can you run it over to forensics, Tony? They may be able to tell us when it was fired.
Sir?
I'll see what our friend has to say for himself. Where did you get the gun, Mr... We're not going to get very far if you won't even tell me your name.
I'm not saying anything to you or anyone else. You get WPC Paige in here, you'll find out all you need to know.
I want your name and some idea of what this is all about, or you won't be seeing anybody.
All right. Then I'll just sit here and get me a down. I've got plenty of time.
And he won't say why he wants to see me.
No, Mr. Munro's been talking to him, but he won't tell him anything, not even his name. But I shouldn't worry about it. It's probably just some nutter you've met in the course of your travels who wants a bit of attention.
Oh, he just managed to get himself a gun along the way. Mm. So how's Reggie's heart after his little surprise?
He's still trying to swallow it.
He doesn't strike me as a fantasist. That's why I called you down.
Sir?
Polly, Sergeant Ackland's explained to you about our visitor?
Yes, sir.
Well, he's still refusing to tell us his name.
Well, hoping you'll have more luck.
OK.
I'll leave you to it.
Hello, Officer Paige. Didn't used to have the beard.
And you were a bit heavier than Mr. Marsh. Thomas Marsh, sir. I dealt with him when his wife died.
You know, I put things right. I've sorted it all out now.
Sorry?
I got rid of good old Richie Layton. I wanted you to be the first to know.
Are you telling us that you've murdered a man called Richard Layton?
You shot him?
It couldn't have been easier. Oh, come on! Are you going to charge me?
Does name Layton mean anything to you?
Yeah, I think it was the drunk driver that killed his wife.
Mr. Marsh, can you take a seat, please? Right. I want to be completely clear about what happened between you and Richard Layton. Did you shoot him?
It's as if I feel lighter. Like this weight has been taken off my shoulders. You ever felt like that? Have you ever experienced that total relief?
Mr. Marsh, I can appreciate that you're upset, but you walked into this station with a loaded revolver and made an outright admission of murder. Now, I don't want to waste any time getting down to the details.
I'll just say exhausted. I haven't slept for... What's the time, Polly? It is Polly, isn't it? Remember, you were very kind.
Why don't we start with where you got the gun?
Look, I just want to lie down. Anywhere I do. Cell will be fine.
Look, Mr. Marsh, you've got to tell us where Layton is. What have you done?
What have I done? I've done what I had to do.
So why won't you tell us where he is?
He's still alive, isn't he?
He was when I left him. But soon he's going to be dead. And all this is going to be over.
Where is he?
I ain't going to tell you where he is. Not until I know for certain that he's gone. Look, just treat this as a murder that's already happened. All right?
Mr. Marsh? I'm arresting you for murder.
St. Hugh's had one gunshot wound admitted last night, but it was a young man. Doesn't match Layton's description.
Well, I suppose that would have been too simple. Thanks anyway.
So, what's the story on this guy Marsh? He doesn't even want a solicitor.
Well, he just wants us to call his mother-in-law.
Here we go. Fatack, 3 years ago. Maria Marsh, maiden name Ross.
Cool. Layton was five times over the limit.
Yeah, I attended the scene. Maria Marsh's injuries were really bad. She was trapped under a bus, died shortly afterwards.
So Marsh reckons he's top the bus driver.
Go on.
Well, that was it, really. I informed Tom Marsh. He was pretty devastated, so I stayed with him for a while.
Took a shame to you then, Polly?
Well, I also stopped him getting done for contempt. You know, he was swearing at the judge.
Sounds like a nutter to me.
Well, it's understandable in his position. I mean, Leighton only got 3 years.
If we're going to find this guy alive, we'd better get a move on. You two, if you get down to the probation office, see if you can get a last known address and then go round it.
Gov.
Sir, do you think Leighton could still be alive?
Well, it's possible. It depends how badly he's hurt. Polly, given the circumstances, I think you better sit in on this.
Of course.
I'll get a lot of old legs, you know. Munster, all right. But he was the pits, so I gave him the elbow.
What time was this?
Oh, about a month ago.
Can you tell me what Mr. Leighton looked like when he left?
Same as you would if you got hammered every day.
Where is everything?
I had to burn it. Even a mattress. Should have seen the state of this place. Bottles everywhere.
Well, you must have kept something. What about the post? Does it still get any?
Well, he got a Reader's Digest offer and a trial-sized pot of Marmite. But I had that. Mind you, it doesn't compensate me for the money I lost on this room.
Surely the housing benefit paid the rent?
Nah, it wasn't just that. He flooded the place. He fell down one night. After he turned the taps on, I had to replace the downstairs ceiling.
Is that his?
No. He was constantly making a racket.
What kind of racket?
Well, screaming in the night, stuff like that. I mean, God knows what he was doing. But he was full of excuses, and I'd had enough. Well, it wasn't worth the inconvenience. Like, I got somebody moving in next week. The same rent, none of the hassle.
Have you seen Mr. Leighton since?
Tuesday week ago, in a shop doorway, same state as usual. Look, I've got to go.
What about a forwarding address?
I tried the gutter.
Oh, thanks for your help, Mr. Chadwick.
Shut the door on your way out, yeah?
Your old heart.
So I'm sure your wife wouldn't want you to be doing this, Mr. Marsh.
Yeah, she didn't want to die either. It wasn't an accident. It was murder.
Her death was caused by reckless driving, for which Leighton was tried and convicted.
You'd think after killing another human being, it would have put him on the straight and narrow. No. I watched him walk straight out of prison and straight into the nearest boozer.
You found out his day of release? How'd you manage that?
You know that feeling you get when you first wake up and you don't really know what's going on? Those are the happiest moments of my life, because for a few seconds, I forget that Maria's dead.
What would she say if she could see what you're doing to yourself? You could spend the rest of your life in prison.
My life's already over. You know, it's a comfort when you make a decision, when you finally get that road to go down.
You want to go to prison? Fine. You've just got one more stage to go through. You've got to give us Leighton.
What time do you finish, Polly?
Why?
Please, what time?
My shift finishes at 10.
Then I'll tell you where to find Leighton 10 minutes before you knock off. That should be enough time.
Enough time for what? For Leighton to die? You're going to dangle us on a string for 7 hours? Well, I'm sorry, Mr. Marsh. I've got better things to do than play games.
It's not a game.
No, prove it. Interview terminated at 15:17.
Well, he must have hidden him somewhere.
Have you seen him at all? Deacon. All right, Reg. Thanks. There's an Anne and Mrs. Ross downstairs.
That's Maria's mother and sister. I met them at the trial.
You have a word?
Yeah.
Jeff, any luck?
Well, since Leighton was evicted from his bedsit last month, he's drawn neither housing benefit or income support, so it suggests he's got no other lodgings yet.
Where's Liz?
She's down in DIU checking on associates. Not looking good so far. Guy's got no family or friends, alcoholic, probably living on the street. No chance of finding him.
Well, Marsh did. Even knew when he was coming out of prison. He must have followed him. Let's go over to his place, see what we can turn up.
Mrs. Ross, what's going on? Is it true what they told us about Tom?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Look, at this stage, he's not telling us everything.
But you think he's done it, don't you? Otherwise, you wouldn't still be holding him.
Well, it certainly looks like it. If there's anything you could tell us.
Like what? Look, you don't think we had anything to do with this?
No, I'm not saying that. But have you seen him recently?
Not for a while. I told him to come round for meals, or talk, anything. But he never came.
Look, when you last saw him, did he say anything about Richard Layton?
No. Why would he?
Well, if what Tom's telling us is true, we need to find Mr. Layton while he still may be alive.
Look, I don't think we can help you.
Holly,
can I have a word?
Excuse me. We're taking Marsh to search his house. The governor wants you there.
Oh, yeah, all right then.
You okay?
Yeah. I'll see you back in a minute then.
Right.
D.I. not here yet?
No, Sarge.
Right, get you ready for your trip, shall we, Mr. Marsh?
Well, I'll wait with him if you want.
It's up to you.
I bet you weren't expecting this when you came on duty.
Look, I don't think we should be discussing the case outside of an interview room. It's not procedure.
I'm hardly going to tell on you, am I?
That's not really the point.
It's just that I felt you should know about what I'd done. You know, seeing you were involved.
Look, I know you've suffered, but the best thing you can do is tell us where to find Layton. While there's still a chance, he may be alive.
Do you really think, after all I've been through, the loss, the anger, the waiting, that I can just turn back? Can you honestly say that if you were in my place, you would just be able to let it go?
Right then.
I don't know what you like to get out of this.
Jeff, let's you take the room straight ahead, please.
Just be careful. I don't like to sleep in a bed. Please, please don't touch that.
Take it easy, Tom.
Calm down, Tom. Come on. I haven't touched this room since she left it.
Sir, can I have a word? Sir, he obviously hasn't got Layton here. If we go trampling over Maria's memory, he'll be even less cooperative.
There's a man out there somewhere, dying slowly. Don't forget that.
Yeah, I know that, but I think there's better ways of winning his trust than this.
Death diary. I found it in the bureau. Layton was released on the 28th of March. The entries start from then. List of abbreviations with times.
And your diary, Mr. Marsh?
So?
Entries start on the day that Layton was released from prison.
Wouldn't know.
Wouldn't you? Thought you told me that you watched Layton go straight from prison into a pub. This a record of his movements?
No.
Thanks very much. First time you've answered one of my questions. There's 10 entries for every day. Marsh must have followed him into the toilet.
All abbreviations, worse luck. Apart from this one.
Ollie's. Could be a drinking buddy or a pub.
Like a cryptic crossword. Abbreviations could mean anything.
Oh, with a deaf-mute suspect, we haven't got much choice, have we?
You must make the entries at the end of each day. Today's date's completely clear.
Go through it and see if there's a pattern. You know, the same thing happening, same day each week.
Well, there is, actually. Same day last week, St. H.
Same as the week before.
Yeah, Nathan's landlord mentioned something about screaming in the middle of the night as if he was in pain.
Long-term illness?
St. H could be St. Hugh's.
It's always listed at 1:30. If we follow the pattern, then he should have been there again today.
Well, Marsh gave himself up at 2:30, so perhaps he saw him as soon as he came out of the hospital. Nip down to St. Hugh's, see if you can trace his movements from there.
Right, Gov.
Let's go.
After all he's been through to end up in prison, it's not fair, it really isn't.
Well, nobody told him to shoot the bus driver, did they?
Ladies, can you keep it calm, please? What is the problem?
For us, for Maria.
What are you talking about?
Don't you care that Tom's in trouble?
Can you ask Polly Page to come to the front desk, please?
I don't care less about Tom Marsh.
It was a regular appointment. He sometimes rolled in late, but today he was on time for a change. Drunk, of course. But that's the problem. Now, Layton's a very quiet man, really. Even he's in extreme pain. Here we are. Now, may I ask why you're inquiring?
He may have been assaulted, possibly shot.
Shot? Good God.
What were you treating him for?
He had a drink problem. The body can withstand a high level of alcohol abuse before it begins to show. But Layton has been drinking for a long time. If I'd had my way, he'd be up on the ward right now.
But he was having none of it.
No. He just refused to be admitted. The man's falling apart physically.
We're trying to retrace his steps after he left here, Dr. Hurst.
I left here at about 1:45. Have you tried his home?
He was evicted. We think he's been living rough for some time.
Well, I wouldn't know where he went after he left me.
We've got this diary of his movements this time last week. Your appointment's here, 1:30, St. H. You throw any light on this next entry, Ollie's?
Oh, yeah. St. Oliver's, the church. Well, I suppose he would go there if he's become an itinerant.
A religious alcoholic?
You'd be surprised how many wash down the sacrament with extra strong lager. But no, it's a soup kitchen for the homeless. They run it weekly from 12 o'clock. I didn't know he went, but it would make sense.
She was happy. They both were.
Ladies, if you can't keep it down, unless you asked you to leave.
Jealous of your own sister for making a good marriage.
Jealous? I pitied her.
You're so jealous, even now you can't think of poor Tom.
Why are you trying to split
them out? Yeah,
I was just about to do that, thanks, Reg.
Nobody asked Tom to go kill Leighton. Or at least I didn't.
Neither did I.
Yeah, right.
Anne? Why don't you come in here with me for a minute? Cool off for a bit. Reg, make Mrs. Ross a cup of tea, would you? Have a seat.
Look, I'm sorry. She just makes me so mad sometimes. Look, you don't need this, I know.
Look, what did you mean about not asking Tom to kill Leighton? Are you suggesting that your mother did?
No. No, of course not. It's just that, well, Mum told Tom that Leighton was being released from prison.
And how did she know?
Grapevine. Word gets around. People liked Maria.
And why do you think she told him?
She was angry. She still is. She just didn't think what it would do to Tom.
Meaning?
Mum was so proud of Tom. Good engineering job. Good provider. And he was clever there. Always so nice to Mum. So considerate. Drove Maria mad. Was the only one she could talk to.
About what?
He smothered her. In the early years, she thought it was flattering. First started when they met at college. Maria was set for a great job. But somehow, Tom discouraged her. Made her stay at home. Then he even started keeping tabs on her every move. What time she went down to the shops and when she got back. It was horrible.
And your mum didn't know?
No, Mum thinks good girls marry good men and live happily ever after. But it was Tom that killed Maria in the end.
Oh, come on. How can you say that?
She wouldn't have been out that day if it wasn't for him. She told him she was going to the shops.
And where was she really going?
The solicitors.
Take it. Jeff, what do you got?
Sorry, Gov. We've established he was alive at St. Oliver's soup kitchen at about 5 to 2, left 10 minutes later. Now, that's the same as last week, according to the diary. We're just trying to work out the next entry. After Ollie's, it says 2:10 BH.
Well, if he left St. Ollie's at 5 past, and he was at BH by 10 past, he can't have gone far, can he? All right, keep me informed.
That's assuming he goes to BH every week, of course.
BH. Bear's Head. Of course, a hot ball of soup followed by a lager chaser.
What time is it?
Just after 5.
Could still be alive, couldn't he?
Just.
Polly, Jeff Daly's just called. There's no sign of Leighton yet.
Well, I've just been talking to Maria's sister.
And?
I'm beginning to feel like Maria's mother. Sometimes I can't see what's right in front of me.
Richard Leighton, what does he look like?
5'8", grey hair, beard, late 50s.
Doesn't ring a bell.
He would have come over from St. Oliver's.
Oh, well, he wouldn't have come in here then. I don't let any of that lot in. Bunch of dossers, ain't they?
You sure?
Sorry.
BH isn't the Bear's Head then. What if BH is a person he met? It's just ridiculous to think we can find him from this diary.
What else can we do?
Well, like the governor said, can't have got too far.
Why'd you turn yourself in? Why didn't you just wait?
I wanted her to know.
Why?
Make you feel important, does it?
No.
No. But it puts you in control, doesn't it? Just the way you controlled your wife.
She wouldn't have even been out that day if it hadn't have been for you.
What do you mean?
She wasn't shopping, Mr. Marsh. She was on her way to a solicitor to get a divorce. She'd had enough of the jealousy, enough of having to account for every second.
That's not true.
Who knows what would have happened if she hadn't been in a hurry, if she hadn't been so scared of you.
You don't believe that, Polly. You saw me the day she died. I loved her more than anything else in this world.
Oh, yeah, I saw you the day she died. Well, that's why I'm here, isn't it? Because you thought you'd be able to fool me the same way you fooled Maria's mother.
Leighton was scum. He deserved to die for what he did to her.
No, no. You're a premeditated murderer who tracked down a defenseless man and put him down like a dog. And you're proud of it. You came in here to crow about it to Polly. Well, are you still proud, Mr. Marsh? Are you still proud now that you know she and I know exactly what sort of man you are?
I did not kill her. I killed Leighton.
And does it still feel good, Mr. Marsh?
What's the time, Polly?
Why?
Because I'm tired of all of this. He's dead. We all know it. He's behind all Gillette's flats in the boiler house.
Interview terminated at 17:25.
Okay, Gov.
What is it?
BH, boiler house behind the flats. Come on.
Polly.
It's WPC Page.
That wasn't true, was it? About the divorce. It was just a trick, right? Part of the interviewing game.
We don't play games, Mr. Marsh.
Here. Got him.
Ambulance. Back of Orchard House. Police at scene. Is he dead?
Yep.
Placed it go. It's not a lot of blood. There's no blood at all.
I followed him every day for 2 months. Then I got a gun. Bought it off some guy in a pub. Tested it once in a rubbish tip, which is the only time I ever fired it.
Then how did you kill him?
Every week after the soup handouts, he used to go to the boiler house to keep warm. That's where I found him. I didn't even have to draw the gun. He was rolling around on the floor, begging me for an ambulance.
And you left him to die?
What was I supposed to do, eh? Save him? Just the sight of me gave him a heart attack. Mine was the last face he ever saw.
But he didn't die of a heart attack, Mr. Marsh. The hospital report says he suffered renal failure. He killed himself. With booze. Perhaps with guilt. But you didn't kill him. He probably didn't even know who you were.
He did. He had to.
He was dying when you arrived. The only charge you're likely to face is possession of a firearm.
It is not an offence to fail to render aid when needed. No guilt can be attached to not lifting a finger.
But I am guilty. I have to be.
Oh, yeah, Mr. Marsh, you are. But not of murder.